I'm happy with that. A straight polka for less than two big ones. But what will this big one, my mechanic Ed China, think? After all, he's going to have to fix it.
Geezer?
Hello, mate. How you doing?
I'm very well. How are you?
I'm impressed. You've got us a 70s supercar.
This You're impressed. I'm chuffed, mate. It's a Porsche 928. I've got us a Porsche.
You have indeed. No, this is good. This
no,
is nice.
I'm so proud of it. It's a cracking car.
So what's the catch?
There is a catch. There's always a catch with the cars I find. Unfortunately, as we're down the front, I'll start here. Headlamp. It doesn't go up and down. Neither of them do. But it's probably just a loose wire, a switch, or a...
Or a motor, which would be a problem. This is, being a supercar, it's got supercar priced parts as well. So it could be like £300 a pop.
What? £300 for a motor? Yeah. You'll just take it out, clean it, and
well,
put it...
I'll do that first, obviously, but we'll see what happens. But it could get expensive, this.
It won't get expensive. They'll be fine.
And these,
the other thing...
they're horrid.
Non-standard BBS alloy wheels. Somebody somewhere thought they'd be quite chic on the car, but they just ruin it.
Yeah, we've got to get rid of those. It's 280s.
They are nasty. And the other thing is the paintwork. Have you seen it? It's horrible.
Well, there's a few little bits and pieces, but again, it's quite straight.
It is very, very straight. The bodywork has got no dents, no marks in it at all, and these cars do suffer with the old dents because they're aluminium, a lot of the panels. However, because I bought the car so cheap, we've got £1,400 left in the budget, and I thought we'd throw it all at the car.
I think we'll have
and to. And we'll paint it.
Okay, well, should we do that near the end, perhaps? Because obviously you've got a lot of other expensive possibilities coming up.
We're going to paint it, Ed. Even if we do it by hand.
Let's have a look at it, see what else we've got.
In it, it's lovely. Leather interior, it's got everything. Yeah, automatic, it's a real cruiser.
It has good, but it's also got cruise control and air conditioning.
Which is fantastic.
Do they work?
It's fantastic. It's got
so you haven't actually checked that then?
No. the paintwork around the back, yet again, is very flaky. Car of the year. No signs of accident damage.
A little bit of paint dodging.
Yeah, but don't worry about it, because we are going to paint the whole car. I can see it. But nice and straight, no dents, no nastiness. It's great, isn't it?
It is good. It's good. Yep. It's very good, actually.
Right, now, the other big issue with this car is I didn't drive it.
At all?
At all.
Does the engine run?
The engine goes and it sounds really sweet,
but
the problem is,
it's
a V8. The problem is, it was sat for a long time and it had no MOT and I didn't want to drive it because I didn't know how safe it would be with the brakes and the exhaust and stuff like that. So I didn't drive it, but I got the feeling that it's going to drive okay.
Okay, has it got a good service history?
It's got no service history, and that's a big buying no-no with a car like this. But because it was so cheap, it was only £1,600, I thought it was worth a punt. It's definitely worth a gamble. It's something I wouldn't recommend you do at home, buying a car without a service history like this.
Dangerous.
But for the money, I reckon we can turn this around and we can end up with a car that we can be so proud of. Let's get this car right. Yes?
Okay.
Okay, cool. Now we need to get it back to your workshop.
You do indeed, okay.
We're not going to drive it.
How about you push and I'll steer?
You're kidding me.
No.
I'm never going to push you in this.
That's the way to go.
Right, you ready?
Yep.
And brake off, Ed.
All right, go on then.
None of that comedy nonsense.
Yeah. Okay, don't push too quick though, because the brakes are a bit dodgy. Come on. And you know, a couple of miles to go.
More or less any old car that has been standing will need attention to the brakes, but let's hope that this time the whole system isn't shot. That could be very expensive.
I can get a reasonable view of the brakes from here, but actually what I'm going to do is take them all apart so I can have a really good thorough look. I'm going to start with the caliper. Well, here's the front caliper off our Porsche, so I'm just going to take the pads out to get a better look at the caliper. Couple of pins here. Okay. Now, when I had to get this off the car, I had to kind of wiggle it around a bit to try and push the piston back inside the caliper, and it was actually very sticky, which is not a good sign. It should sort of flow, you know, a bit of resistance, but it should flow back reasonably well. And you can see there's quite a bit of corrosion around the outside of the piston, but also the dust cover has really, really perished, which is not a good sign either. So I think really, for peace of mind, I'm just going to replace this with a reconditioned unit.
The pads look fine, but they are cheap, so we will replace them. And good news, the discs aren't pitted and are pretty good. Rather than spend around £40 a corner, we'll keep using these.
Okay, you ready, Paul?
I'm ready.
Cool. Okay, right, now push straight down.
Down.
Okay. Okay, and then up.
Up.
And then down again.
Down.
Is that a good pedal?
Yeah, it's getting firm. Yeah, it's pretty good.
Wicked. Okay, I think we'll do that. That's cool.
And with the air definitely out of the system, just tighten the nipple and that's it.
Now, I thought that the brakes were going to be absolutely appalling on this, but on this corner alone, we only had to do the caliper and the pads. Now, if the rest of the car lets us off that lightly, we have got a right result.
All four corners done, our Porsche is now definitely getting closer to being a runner. Next up, that body. Now, the bodywork is actually pretty straight. There aren't any real major dents, but all over the car, the paintwork is completely shot. You can see a really good example of this just here, where the lacquer has bubbled up and flaked off and left some really rather nasty flat paint beneath. Now, the only way really of fixing this is by doing a full body respray.
But it's not an easy job to do alone, and I'm going to ask Paul back to give me a hand. To prep for a respray, we have to remove all the main parts of the shell so they can be sprayed separately. That means the lights, tail cone and front bumper need to come off, which, thanks to Porsche's top build quality, is quite a time-consuming job.
We're trying to get this front bumper off, and it turns out two of the bolts are hidden underneath these cowlings behind the lights, so we have to get the lights out. Now, you may remember, they don't work, but handily, Porsche, in their infinite wisdom, supplied us with a manual override, which is this little knob here. So I just turn this for a long time, and I think we'll find that the headlights will then, there we go, start to pop out on their own accord. Now, even though we've been very good in putting all the nuts and bolts coming off the car safely away into boxes, there's going to be quite a few of them, and I think I'm not going to have a chance of remembering where everything goes. So the ones that I can, I'm putting back onto whatever I'm taking off the car. So this is the headlight, got some nuts there and some screws there. I know exactly where they should be. Now, to make a really good job of our respray, we do have to remove the windows, but I'm really worried about damaging these expensive and very delicate trims in the process. Now, the rubbers are actually quite perished, so I can replace those later on, so I've decided to actually cut through them, keeping the trims intact, but also being able to remove the glass.
If you want to do a second-rate respray, you can skip taking the windows out, but we want every seam of the paint to be A1, so we're going to remove them. A fitter could do this for you for a call out of around £100.
Now, it's really important that all this rubber sealant is removed, because if you painted over it, it would go hard and crispy, and then when it came to put the new rubber back on with the window, it wouldn't fit properly, and chances are the window would leak, so it really has got to go.
Now, we've taken apart most of this car, but as you can see, you've got the tailgate and the doors still attached to this vehicle, and that's because although they will come off later on, I actually need to do some rubbing down. Now, before we can paint the car, we need to make sure that the paint that's here at the moment is a good surface. So where it's actually still quite smooth, you need to go over it with a scouring pad and kind of rough it up just to give it a good key. But where the lacquer has bubbled and flaked off, you need to go with something a bit stronger, 120 grit paper, and just rub it back just to make sure it's a nice, smooth, perfect surface ready for paint. It's going to be a long job.
Even with two of us working flat out, this is hours of prep.
Now, before I can take the door off the car, I need to take a whole load of stuff off the door. I'm going to start with the door card.
Click here to subscribe.